guys.
All right.
Tonight. Oh, come on. There we go. Tonight, I'm going to be doing a one-step cooking 2-pound crawfish boil. Yum! Well, this is good. I've never done this before. So, the cooking instructions says, do not preheat on grill or in toaster. Oh, do not prepare on grill or in toaster oven. Cook from frozen. Cook to 165. I can't talk tonight. Okay. Conventional oven. Preheat oven to 350. Okay, so getting that going. Remove bag from the box and spread ingredients out in bag by shaking. Place bag on a baking sheet, clear window up. Place in the middle of the oven and bake 35 to 40 minutes. Okay, so I guess I didn't need the foil. I was thinking I needed foil for some reason. Check the food is cooked thoroughly by checking the center internal temperature of potatoes using a food thermometer. I don't know if I have one of those. I don't know how to check on that. Careful it's hot. Remove from oven and let stand for 5 minutes to complete the cooking process. Gently rock the bag back and forth and distribute sauce evenly. Cut open hot bag carefully and pour into serving dish or cut bag open and gently remove contents with tongs and slotted spoon. Pour desired amount of remaining sauce over the crawfish and vegetables. Serve. Failure to use a baking sheet may cause damage to the bag, food, and or oven. It says you can do a microwave also, but I'm doing it in the oven. So give me one moment, I'll be right back. Okay. Let's get this opened up. Ow. Oh, it's a... I thought it was going to be a clear bag. It's a brown bag. Interesting. Okay. A bag for box and spread ingredients out and bag by shaking. Okay. Place bag on the baking sheet, clear window up. Remember that roll. I don't know if you can see that roll or not. I'm adding stuff to dust in here. Okay. So, clear window up. Place in the middle of the oven and bake 35 to 40 minutes. So, okay. Put it in the oven. See you back in here a while. Oh, excuse me. Okay, I'm back. It should be done. I don't have a thermometer. I'm sure my mom has one around here, but I have no idea where it could be because she moves everything around all the time. But I do have a fork. I can tell if my potatoes are done that way. If you do this, there's a lot of steam coming out. Yeah, you can see that right there. Knee reaching over your head. I'm not going to get burnt. Oh yeah, hold on. Yum. Alright, I'm going to fill my plate. And I will be back in a bit. Hey guys, how's it going? Tonight I'm having, like you see in the previous part where I fixed it. I heard something. Crawfish boil. Yum! So I'm hoping this tastes good. I'm hoping. So, I'm not really sure how to go about eating these things, especially since I have nails on. This is going to be interesting. I didn't plan this part out very well. And it is still very, very hot. Oh yeah, I definitely did not plan this out very well. Howie, howie, hot. Yum. That's good. Hello, Mountain Dew for something change. I cannot talk tonight. I cannot get the bottle open tonight. I'm having alley issues tonight, and the nail's trying to come off. I don't have the salon kind. I had to go to Walmart. I'm not fancy. Love to go to the salon, but I haven't got there yet. Yeah, nail salon. I think I said the wrong word for a second because I'm thinking hair salon, but I guess they have nail salons also. I'm not up on all this fancy stuff. Well, to me, this is fancy. I'd say it's fancy, but to me, it's fancy. Anywho. Okay, let's try a little bit of corn on the cob. Yum. It's good. So how are you guys doing? Good, I hope. A little bit of spice to it. I like it. A little bit, but it's not too much. Crawdads, of course, the potatoes from the cob, and the sausages. First time ever doing something like this. The only time I've ever had, well, It's not the item. Usually when I've had crawdads, it's just a few of them. And when we've gone to the Chinese restaurant, I mostly get sushi. And I'll occasionally get a couple of crawdads on my plate. It's usually not a huge amount like this. Crawdads. But, I forgot about it. Years and years ago, my husband and I, we used to go down to the creek. And I go wading in the water, my pant legs roll up to my knees, barefooted in the creek, and catching crawdads, probably to play with them, but also at one time, just for shits and giggles, we caught a whole bunch, took them home, and cooked them. So, I don't think I fixed them right though. I didn't have any seasoning in them, so they're like really, really bland. They weren't as good. Alright, let's talk about another crawdaddy. Ducky. Some yuckies. I'm not eating the yuckies. Look at my scissors. I can't ever get organized. It would help. I'm 99 years old before I get organized. Already. Sorry, I'm not eating no yucky. It may not have been totally yucky, but I just don't want to take a chance. I don't know what it was. Didn't look too pretty. A potato. Maybe you have followed me for a little while. You know that I get full fast, so I can see me getting full on this really quick, especially with the potatoes. I almost said that wrong. Try to say potatoes. What was wanting to come out instead of potatoes. There we go, that one came out better. The seafood stuff is a lot of work. Good grief. Jeez. Mound of Buddy, your innards aren't very pretty. A little dissecting here. Curiosity killed the cat. Satisfaction brought it back. Hair is like driving me crazy. Sort of interesting, and nothing edible there, but kind of sort of interesting. Well, I find it interesting. Some of you in the mall might think it gross. Sorry. Didn't mean to gross you out. I like biology type stuff. Science. There's no more meat in there. It's just the tails. It'll fail. That's all you got in there. It's worth eating. Keep expecting to lose one of these in a crawdad. That'd be cool. Oh, that works too. Oh, excuse me. Wow. Itty bitty little tiny piece of meat. Excuse me, meat. I got hiccups. Again, well, burps. This might take me a while. Alright. Get rid of the carnage. Yucky, 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 yucky. All right. There for the moment. Get a couple of these open. And lost your booty. It's in the trash. Okay, you've only got half a booty. And your booty broke. Come on. Yucky, yucky, yucky. Get rid of the legs off my sausage. Wanting to walk away. Gotta get rid of some of the carnage so I can see what I got in here. think there's any. Ow, owie. Meat in there. Nope. Ow. That hurt. Jeez, how about little legs everywhere? Okay. Now I can see a little more what I got going on here. How about you guys? Have you tried the boxed 2-pound crawdad boil like this? Not bad. Well, it'll work. It's not bad. A lot of legs. And nuts, all the legs everywhere. Make sure I don't actually throw away all my tails. Messy, messy. I brought my little crabby things out. I thought maybe I'd need them, but yeah, not really. You've tried these. What do you think of it? I like it so far, other than being a little bit of work to get everything open, getting a little morsel. Pretty good. I used to have fun hunting crawdads just for fun, not for eating. Just to pick them up and see if I can keep from getting pinched and all that kind of stuff. Like playing with them. We had a kiddie pool in our basement at one point, and my husband had a fish pump on it to keep the water circulating. We got some those little little feeder goldfish. We had some of those in the tank. We had 50 of them to be exact, and a couple of crawdads, something like that. Well, one day we ran out of fish food, and my husband was working a 12-hour shift, so it was going to be hours before he got home, and I knew the fish were hungry. So here I am thinking and trying to come up with something that I could feed them. So they wouldn't be hungry. So in our cabinet, I seen an old box of grape nuts that I hadn't eaten for quite a while. I got the bright idea thinking, hey, I can feed the fish grape nuts for now until we can get the store once hubby gets home. We didn't have, only had the one car, and hubby had the car. We didn't have a phone at the time. And at the time, I wasn't working. So, I got creative. Yeah. That's such a good idea. Word of caution, never, ever feed your fish grape nuts. I didn't realize it. I didn't think about it until later. But grape nuts swell when they get wet. 48 of those fish blew up after eating the grape nuts and literally exploded. I'm not even joking. Literally exploded. So the crawdads had quite a meal of the exploding fish. Two of the little fishies actually managed to survive. So we put them in our 55-gallon tank instead of the pool after everything else died, thanks to me. But we named one Lucky because it was lucky to live, and the other one was Tang. They eventually grew to be the length of my hand. So, but yeah, don't feed your fish grape nuts. Hubby's still teasing me about that to this day. I'm the great fish killer. And again, he teased me about being the plant killer too, because I have a black thumb of death. I've actually killed water plants. I've killed cactuses. I've killed burger plants. I am not good with plants. Come on. Minus the leg. I don't want a leg. Almost done. Well, getting closer. Oh, did I? Okay, I thought I ripped it in half. It's like, no! That was salty. Piece of sausage. A very mild sausage. It's good though. That's probably where the salt flavor came from, was the sausage. Because it's pretty salty. I swear I'm gonna lose one of these nails in a minute. Feels like it at least. Case you're wondering what I'm cutting, it's like a little green stuff right there. Not eating that. Really? Okay, come on. There you go. Made me think of the bodies at the floor. All the bodies I got here. Hope nobody takes offense to that. I don't mean it in a. It just made me think of that song. So many little parts here. Tomorrow's trash day. Take the trash out after this. Stinking up the house. Fishy. Okay. I thought I broke it in half for a second there. Ow, 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 ow. That nail feels like it's going to come flying off. Okay, I don't want your little extra goodies. I think I'm going to eat the crawdad for now, and then I'll eat the rest, corn and all that, later as a snack. I'm getting full as it is. Go figure, right? I think I say that every time I do a video. I don't mean to, but I get full so fast. I'm trying to get where I eat a little more, but yet I'm trying to exercise more too. I got a Fitbit, but I haven't been able to get working yet. Piss me off. So I'm hoping I can get it to working so I can actually start working on walking more. Come on. Fingers. Cooperate. There you go. Alright. What do we got left? We got two more after this one. Okay. Oops. Dropped one on the floor. Here, kitty kitty. She wouldn't eat it. She's so picky. Biggest cat I have ever had. Snuggles is, that is. Snuggle bug. You know, you have a picky cat if she doesn't eat Fancy Feast cat food. Any canned food I give her, she'll lick the gravy off. That's it. Okay, spoil a brat. I don't want your legs. I want your booty, not your legs. I said I wanted your booty. Really? You can be stubborn, huh? Come on, fingers. Is your
Got ya. Last one. Last bite. Okay. So, anyhow, hope you guys have enjoyed. If not, sorry. And if you don't like it, that's okay. Everybody has their own taste. Some people like some stuff that others don't, so. It was good though. We'll give it that much. Messy. Very messy.
Yeah.
Probably better wash my hands instead of putting out all of the white towel. I think this is a success. I didn't rip off any fingernails. Felt like it, but I didn't. So anywho, wait a second here. Let me finish cleaning up my mess. Stick my arm and everything. I don't need to accidentally take a crawdad leg to bed with me. Ugh. Okay, so anywho, hope you guys enjoyed. If not, that's okay. You know, to each their own. So, but hello to all my new subscribers, and I hope that everybody is doing good. If not, I hope things get better. If you're new to my page and you're not. Excuse me. Subscribed yet? Hold on. Hold that thought. Well, I explode over here. Think I'm done. If you've not hit that subscribe button, hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you again soon. I have plans for more seafood-ish type things coming up, as well as everything in between. So, stay tuned, and hopefully I'll have some more yummies. I'm hoping to, in the future, add more, like, tutorials to the beginning and stuff. If you guys like that kind of stuff, so. If you do, let me know. If you don't, let me know. So, alright, I'm gonna scoot. And I'll catch you guys later. Bye-bye.